will share with you some tips and tricks on how to take macro photographs. Macro photography is when an object is captured on film and is at least quarter of a life size or larger. First, let us look at the tools you will need to shoot macro photography. You will need a macro lens which is capable of getting very high quality close-ups compared to other lenses. However, if you don't have a macro lens, don't worry, because I will show you three techniques on how you can modify your own normal lens. You will also need a camera shutter release remote, either a wired one or a wireless. If you do not have these remote shutter release, don't worry, because you can just use your camera self-timer. The cardinal rule is to never touch your camera to release your shutter, because any small vibrations on your camera can smudge or make your picture blurry. In macro photography, the key point is to get critical focus. Usually, we just use autofocus, but that is not helpful at all in macro photography. Instead, we have to move our camera back and forth from the object and fine-tune it by using the focus ring. Of course, you don't take macro photographs handheld. You have to mount your camera on a tripod. I'm just displaying it to you right now. This flower is facing down, so I'm going to use this. See how helpful this hand is. Without it, the rose was facing down and I couldn't get the angling down, angling right. But now it has raised the rose up and the angle is perfect. The camera and optic is now set up. Now I'm going to focus it. And to focus it, I use the zoom in button and then carefully focus the lens. Now that I focused the object, I'm going to use my wired shutter release. And since I enabled the mirror lock function in my camera, I press it once to lock the mirror and twice to take the actual picture. I will show you how to make this. It's a great helping hand and keeps your object still while you're taking the macro photograph. Basically, I super glued this small clamp onto this mirror, like you can see over here. I clamped this arm with the tripod leg using this bigger clamp. In macro photography, you cannot rush through the focusing process. It takes a whole lot of patience and time to get the critical sharpness you're looking for. I will show you a technique that I use to quickly focus my camera. First, you have to set the camera into the macro position. Then turn the live view on. Then use a ruler and slide it through until the ruler comes into focus, or until the edge of the ruler specifically comes into focus. Then, mark the position at which the edge is focused from the rear of the camera. Take a thin PVC pipe and mark it. Then cut the pipe a little bit longer so you can hold it at this length. I know at this plane everything will be in focus, so I move my flower up to that point. And the flower is now pretty much focused. To fine-tune this, I can adjust my focusing ring. If you don't have a macro lens, you can buy a close-up filter which fits in front of your lens. But if you don't have a close-up filter, you can just buy a $2 magnifying glass like I have here and hold it in front of your focusing ring. Another way to convert your normal lens into A macro lens is to simply just reverse it. And by reversing it, I mean to put the back side facing outward and the front side facing inward. Like this. Now let me take my macro lens out and show you how it looks when you reverse the lens. You do not actually have to hold it like this. There is an accessory called the lens reversal ring. I don't have it, so I'm showing it to you like this. The third option is to use a lens extension tube. This tube sits in between the camera and your lens and allows your lens to take macro photographs. All right, enough talk. Let's go outside and do some macro photography.